Though several strides have been made towards gender equality within the teaching profession, there are still many battles left to fight on behalf of female educators, says President of the St. Lucia Teachers Union, Don Howell. Addressing the gathering of mainly female educators at the trade union's International Women's Day Conference, he noted that in order for these battles to be won, the union must ensure there is no gender bias within it and that it remains a cohesive unit.
We recognize the struggles of the union involving fights for the rights of women and the advancement of gender equality. The SRNO clause, which forced women out of work because they were pregnant and unmarried, was one of the first fights for women equality in recent history, won by the St. Lucia Teachers Union. In recent times, the SLTU had enshrined in its collective agreement a clause to ensure that women do not lose their vacation due to maternity leave. Finally, the SLTU had to mature over the years to ensure that women had a forum in which they could discuss and articulate their issues, and hence the formulation of the SLTU Status of Women's Committee, which is constituted in the manner that it is today.
Founder of Helen's Daughters, Kiflin Karu, was the guest speaker at the conference. She used the opportunity to converse with those present, highlighting the challenges faced by female teachers.
As women in the Caribbean, as black women, Caribbean people, we are known for our resilience, but it's to a fault. How many of us know of teachers that they go through these stresses, they go through the fatigue, they go through the bad eating, they go through giving away their own money, ignoring their own children and listening to their students instead? They wait for retirement. That's the goal. Retirement, retirement, retirement. A year or two right before retirement, boom, this person dies of heart disease or a stroke. How many of us know of somebody like that? Exactly. Today, I know that we have this theme, and there was this expectation of, you know, some inspiring speech and so on. But in the theme, there's two main words that we have to focus on: equality and sustainability. And I always ask persons, how can we expect an equal world when our teachers are unequal, when they're in an unequal environment?
The trade union's president has expressed disappointment in the education ministry for failing to acknowledge the contribution of female teachers over the past year.
One thing that is very disheartening is that the Ministry of Education, while it continues to move ahead with face-to-face instruction, is seemingly turning its back and have not, to this date, celebrated the work that women have done on the online platforms. We have done tremendous work. We have a lot to fall back on. And the impact that it had on women, female teachers, is profound. And that has to be celebrated. But do not allow the actions of the Ministry of Education to dampen our spirits. Let us celebrate and continue to celebrate ourselves as true professionals.
Female educators, meanwhile, have been encouraged to not limit themselves and to not shy away from the issues that constantly confront and hinder them from moving forward.
Let us remember that we cannot do it alone. We need each other. We need the circle of strong women to encourage and build other women. We need to lift other women up and stand together side by side and live bravely. This is what we are called to do.
The SLTU president has expressed confidence that, surrounded by the competent women of the trade union, the organization will rise and do better. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.